We have here an announcement of Rolling Loud Miami 2021, and I'm very confused by the lineup, honestly. I think maybe it makes sense for Rolling Loud lineup because, they have the usually the same group of people performing every single Rolling Loud. But the headliners are very odd, right? A$AP Rocky, Travis Scott, and Post Malone on consecutive days. The one that really sticks out for me is Rocky. I'm a big fan of his, have been for a while, big fan of A$AP Mob and all the, associated members in that crew. Still think A$AP Nas is probably quite possibly the most talented member, maybe the most laziest of the group. It's a shame that he hasn't really taken music seriously and kind of decided to become an Instagram influencer, which probably I don't blame him for. I think if you get paid to just be able to wear, Comme des Garçons and shout people about, you being the first person to wear Supreme, it probably is more lucrative than having to slave away in the studio, make a record, record videos, do promo. It's just annoying. So I get the appeal of doing that, right? Just kind of designing colorways for Reeboks and stuff is probably way more fun to do and way more lucrative to do for somebody like him, who's probably never ever going to be like a A-tier, artist. He's probably always going to stay in some sort of like lower level regardless of his talent, just because of the way things are. But he definitely is my favorite in the group overall. I definitely am a big fan of A$AP now. So again, big fan of A$AP Mob and that whole crew. But it's not, I'm not out of turn in saying that Rocky's kind of had a bit of a disappointing career, maybe in terms of fans, maybe not in his eyes. I'm sure he probably sees himself more as a, cult figure, icon sort of dude, right? And he's not really concerned about not being the biggest superstar in the world, but he has so much potential and so much tools at his disposal to kind of really reach the higher echelons if he wanted to, but it's just never really worked out. I'm not sure it's because of the music he tries to make, of the albums not really being as cohesive as they probably should do, his just inability maybe to turn around work quickly. I don't know. Whatever the issue is, something's happened in the last 3 years that's basically left A$AP Rocky in a position where he's kind of flattered to deceive a little bit, right? And it feels like in the kind of battle between the guys with braids and the guys that get mistaken for each other, and ironically by paparazzi to get a rise out of them, because that was one of the common memes in it with all these street paparazzi people. Whenever they saw Travis, they'd call him Rocky. Whenever they said Rocky, they call him Travis, right? To kind of just get a reaction out of them and obviously go a bit viral. Obviously, over time, that maybe turned into an issue. I'm not too sure what happened, but I always get the feeling that Rocky and Travis don't really like each other. I'm not too sure what that is. It might have to do with Thailand, Odd Future, because the Odd Future and Thailand weren't really that fans of Travis. I remember when Travis was wearing their, this is a weird thing to remember, but I remember there was a point where I think there was Odd Future Vans, I think they were Vans or Converse, one or the other, and I think Travis was really rocking them hard. He loved them. I think he bought every pair, and I never saw Tyler acknowledge him once. Like zero, nothing. It was always kind of like dust, and I don't know what that was. Maybe it was because of, his association with Big Sean, and Tyler had that weird thing with Big Sean in terms of labels and cosigns and stuff. I don't know. Something happened there. But I always got the feeling that they're not the closest, right? So I also felt like the industry maybe pitted them against each other and maybe anointed Travis as the winner in terms of that battle, right? And Travis has kind of gone on to become this global superstar, right? In terms of his appeal, he's basically, he's basically, what is he? He's basically safe in terms of brands because he hardly speaks. He doesn't do anything crazy. He's not involved in many big scandals. He kind of keeps his head he kind of keeps his head down and just does his work, right? For the most part, does a couple of remixes, jumps on a few singles here and there, and just keeps it moving. And it feels like, people have kind of anointed Travis as kind of like the winner in that battle. But it does feel odd considering, the reception of the albums, where we are now in culture, where we are now with artistry, that A$AP Rocky will be headlining a date for, Rolling Loud in Miami. It just feels odd. It feels like something that might have happened in 2018 that might have made more sense. But in 2021, are people really checking for Rocky like that? Or is his music streaming so well? And because of the fact that he's got such a broad appeal from guys to girls, from fashion to rapper people, that it just makes sense if you're Rolling Loud and you want to really guarantee you sell out. Because I imagine, especially after the pandemic and how long people have been without going to events and events, being able to put an event if you're Rolling Loud and you're kind of booking this dearth of artists. I'm sure not all of them are going to be paid, but still a high percentage of them will be paid. You want to make sure that it's going to be worth your while. You don't want to have an event that's only selling 70% of the tickets. You want to make sure it's in a high 80s, maybe potentially 90s, and obviously selling out. So the best way to do it is to cover your bases and kind of get every sort of demographic of people, because I guess in this respect, Rocky, Travis and Post Malone cover different kind of groups of fans in the hip hop kind of ecosystem. Obviously Post Malone isn't a rapper, but he still kind of, you know, straddles in that world somewhat, so that makes some sense in that regard. But if you're Rick Ross, would you be upset that you're not headlining of Rolling Loud and Rocky is? If you're Playboi Carti, would you be upset? Lil Baby, maybe he's had a crazy couple of years, should he be headlining that instead of Rocky? 21 Savage even, City Girls, considering how much attention they get on the blogs and stuff, maybe they should be headlining. I don't know, it just feels a bit odd. Moneybagg Yo even, come on, there's a lot of people here who are 42 Doug, like when's the last time Rocky had a Billboard hit? I can't really think of. Again, this is not something I care about because I don't look at those Billboard charts, but I know if you're trying to put these events on, you know, you're going to look at all these kind of commercial chart listings and stuff, because they're going to play a big role in terms of who gets what slot, ensuring and making sure you sell through the event. So a lot of people on there that would be, I don't know, a little bit annoyed if they're not headlining. But again, maybe that just goes to show how much credit in the bank Rocky's got from all those years of kind of, you know, doing his bit with his albums, A$AP Mob tapes, you know, his features, his allegiances and stuff, or maybe put him there. I don't know, it just feels strange. This would be similar to like if Kanye West was headlining a date. It's like, who's really checking for his music right now? I know the legacy, I know what he's done in the past, but in terms of what have you done for me lately, which is what the music industry is, it just seems a little bit odd. That's the only thing, it just seems a little bit odd. The rest of the dates are pretty solid. Travis Scott headlining on a Saturday, Young Thug, Roddy Ricch, Kodak Black, Gunna, Sway Lee, Don Toliver, Lil Durk, Nav, Polo G, Sheckle West, which is interesting considering everything that's happened against him, legalities and all that malarkey. So goes to show people don't get cancelled hip hop, as I've always said. Young Dolph, Chief Keef, Coi Leray, Wale, Blueface, J.I., Keith Glock, loads of pretty good people. Post Malone, Sunday, Lil Uzi Vert, Nice, The Baby, Megan Thee Stallion, Tiger, Gucci Mane, Rod Wave, Lil TJ, Jack Harlow, Lil Yachty, Suicide Boy, Pooh Shiesty, St. John, Young Blue, T-Pain, Fetty Wap, Mulatto, Rika Nasty, Puya, Tyler Yewa, OGZ, Young Nudy, 5 Year Foreign, K-Camp, Shorty, Partisan Fontaine. Really? What is he going to be performing there? Odd, isn't it? Odd listing that regardless. But Ruby Rose is there, so that's a good look for her. Bobby Fishgale. Yeah, Mariah the Scientist, that's a nice look for her too. BFB the Pac-Man, oh wow, it's amazing, really good listing. So yeah, interesting list of people here, I'm not going to lie. Interesting list of headliners. Kodak Black is there too, he'd be interested. Gunna, because not headlining, interesting, isn't it? Really interesting considering, but I don't know, maybe I'm reading too much into it and Rocky's still got that allure for most people, but interesting that he's headlining a day on Rolling Loud in 2021. You know, but maybe it's because we've missed a year. Do you know what I mean? We've legitimately skipped a year, so this makes sense if it's 2020. Maybe with his Rihanna stuff going on. I don't know. It just feels odd.